In order to create meaningful learner-centered virtual programs, we as instructional designers and facilitators need to adapt our engagement techniques. Why? Because the virtual learning environment is radically different than the traditional classroom. Thanks to the tools available on virtual platforms like Cisco WebEx and the popular Adobe Connect, it's easier than ever to engage virtual learners as often as needed. For example, breakout rooms are one type of popular tool. Breakout rooms allow groups of two or more participants to meet and collaborate during a larger live online session. They are ideal for training sessions in which teams or groups must work with specific content, like analyzing a case study. An important benefit is that breakout room sessions demonstrate that the virtual classroom can be used to obtain real training results. Fundamentally, there are five things to know about breakout rooms in order to use them most effectively. 1. Breakout rooms are different than chat. Breakout rooms provide more personal classrooms in which participants can talk and collaborate. 2. Different groups can work with different content or on different exercises from one breakout room to the next. 3. Facilitators can move from one breakout room to another. This allows them to work with groups or individuals as needed. 4. Participants won't usually have a facilitator in a breakout room. This means that they will need clear instructions for what to do while they're in the breakout room. And 5. If you have more than one expert at a learning event, you can assign one to each breakout room, and participants can go to the room of their choice for the discussion of their choice. The next step is to understand the capabilities of breakout rooms. One way to do so is to ask the following questions about your particular platform's tool before designing breakout room learning exercises. Is this feature built in? What features are available for use inside the breakout rooms? Can you pre-assign participants to breakout rooms? Can participants move from room to room during an activity? Can whiteboard content created in breakout rooms be brought into the main room and shared with the full group when it reconvenes? Can you record individual breakout activities? Our Virtual Classroom Instructional Designer Certificate course provides this demonstration of using breakout rooms in an online learning event to create participant engagement.
Here's how this is going to work. Each group's going to be assigned an objective from the case study, and you'll be given an activity that's already been developed for you to teach that objective. As a group, what we want you to do is determine the best way to assess that activity given your assigned constraint, which you can see we have listed on the board here, is either going to involve a budget constraint, a time constraint, or a limitation based on who your learners are. Now, while you're doing this activity, we want you to keep a couple things in mind. All right. We want you to think about all of the tools available in your virtual classroom. We also want you to consider what are those tools outside of the classroom that you could use. Of course, remember your assigned limitation. And then at the end, we'll ask you to say whether this is a qualitative or quantitative assessment. Now, here's what we're going to give you. This is an example of what's going to be assigned to Team 1. Each team will get one of these slides loaded into your breakout room after we get them started. Mark and I will divide and conquer. We'll get them loaded for you. So this is what you'll work with to go ahead and to fill in your assessment.
All right, everybody. So we have you in your work group, so everyone should be familiar with those. We do have enough for at least two folks in each group to get started with the discussion. I'm going to let you guys know through timing cues how much time you have left. We're going to give you about 10 minutes. Just remember to make sure that somebody is describe and is annotating on each of the slides that we load, because we are going to pull them back for a fun debrief activity.
As you can see, Mark has brought back each of your slides from your breakout. And we've got Team 1, we've got Team 3, and Team 4 are loaded as such. And then the other two are loaded. If you'll see at the top, it's going to say team number also at the top left-hand corner. You are able to click on these tabs and to take yourself on a gallery walk through the work that has been done by your peers here. So we'd like to ask you to do that now. So just click on each tab. You'll see that we have put the limitation at the bottom left corner of each of the slides so that you understand what the limitation was that each group was working with. Go ahead, review each of them. Give us a green check when you're done. And then afterwards, we'll see if you have any comments or questions regarding what you looked at.
Well-designed breakout room activities can help to change the attitude of your audience with regard to virtual classroom training. Make sure to include it in your instructional designs to help you reach optimal engagement levels. InSync training provides more information about virtual classroom tools, including breakout rooms, in the white paper titled Virtual Classroom Tool Design Basics, a Virtual Engagement Primer. Download it for free under Resources White Papers at www.insynctraining.com. Additionally, our Virtual Classroom Instructional Designer Certificate course provides in-depth application and design instruction. To learn more or to register, visit www.insynctraining.com. Select the Certificates drop-down on the top left-hand side of the homepage. The links for both the white paper and course are included in the video description below.